Hey guys, so in my continuing quest to find the perfect bag for one bag travel, I've continued to look through a lot of different YouTube videos and Amazon reviews, and I stumbled onto a new brand that I hadn't heard of before called Arcedo. And I actually ordered one of their smaller bags, but it's still meant to be kind of a carry-on travel backpack. And the model that I ordered is called the Faro. So this is the bag right here. So as you can see, it's looking a little bit full. So what I've gone ahead and kind of packed what I would say is about a week's worth of clothes. You know, that'll vary depending on how everybody packs and dresses. But so I tried to pack it in with about as much stuff as I think I would need, worst case scenario, for a week's worth of travel, just to see kind of how big the bag would look like, how heavy it would be, and how convenient it would be to pack everything up. And I have to say, I was pretty impressed with the bag, and I'm pretty excited to take you through some of the features that it has. So let's take a closer look. So as I mentioned before, this company, Arcedo, they have two kind of premier bags right now for traveling. This is the model called the Faro. And so the dimensions of the bag are perfect for carry-on on most international and domestic airlines. I think it was 9-14 and about 20 to 22 inches. So it should fit no problem in any overhead bin and even in the kind of metal checking bins. And I really love the design of this backpack. It's really, really cool. I love this color. It's kind of a heather gray material. Seems pretty sturdy. I haven't exposed it to extreme water, but on the whole, it seems to be pretty water resistant. On the outside, the bag is, you know, pretty minimalist as far as the design. It's got two elastic water bottle pockets on the sides, which is really convenient for taking your water bottle through the airport. And then it has a small accessory pocket at the top right here. So this is a good space to put you know, your phone, your wallet, an external battery, headphones, just kind of a lot of different stuff that you might want to tuck in really quickly as you're about to go through the security gate at the airport. And it's also just a good pocket for accessories. In this pocket, I currently have just a USB hub. This has kind of become my new favorite travel hack. You know, when I'm sharing hotel room with other people and everybody has their devices that they want to charge, this is great because one outlet will provide you with five different ports, and you know, there's some that even have six or seven ports. But this is so convenient, and you know, especially when you're traveling internationally and you have adapters that you need to account for, one adapter will get you multiple charges on different devices. So I highly recommend that. So this pocket, it goes pretty deep, as you can see, so it opens nice and wide. And you can definitely fit in a lot of different sized items. Maybe not a tablet or anything like that, but definitely like your phone, as I mentioned, some headphones. I put a lot of my accessory pouches in here as well, so if I have cables or chargers. And then also maybe my passport, if I'm just putting things off really quickly. So a really useful pocket, and it's nice that it offers a little bit of separation from kind of the main compartment, which is what I'm gonna cover next. So as you can see here, the bag really just has kind of that one huge compartment for clothing and for, you know, your main packing items. And so it's really cool because it opens from these zippers here, and the zipper goes all the way down the sides of the backpack, which is great because it's kind of like a clamshell opening. So it lets you open the bag completely, which makes for easy packing, and it kind of lets you see everything that you have in the bag at once. So as you can see here, I have all my clothing, as I mentioned earlier. It's about what I would say is a week's worth of travel. Maybe you can fit a little bit more or less depending on your different needs. So I'll go through and kind of just give a summary of everything that I have in here. And you know, sorry for the disorganization. I just kind of threw these things in a little bit quickly. So with a little bit more care and organization, you should be able to fit a good amount of stuff in here. So what I have in here is, you know, I have some of my undergarments, some socks. I have about three t-shirts here, pair of shorts, pair of shoes. That's great that you can fit an extra pair of shoes, and typically I recommend traveling with two pairs of shoes, one kind of sporty walking shoe and one something a little bit more versatile that you could use to go out at night or something like that. So, you know, I have some Converses here which kind of serve a lot of different purposes, and they very compact, but you can fit a lot of different style shoes in there. I was able to fit in some chukka boots or some high tops as well, if that's kind of more your style. And then I have a few more t-shirts here. So it has a grand total of five t-shirts. And then one cool thing that I really like about the bag is that it comes with compression straps on the inside, which allows you to, you know, after you're done packing, you can just go ahead and tighten them and kind of strap it down to compress it and maybe make a little bit more space. I really like that it's just kind of one big compartment that lies open flat. That makes organization and really efficient use of space. So a lot of bags that are popular these days, such as the Air Travel Pack, which I really love the design on that bag, you know, it has a separate shoe compartment that, while cool, it also goes into the main compartment and takes up space out of that main packing area. So I don't really like that too much, and I probably wouldn't use it on that bag. So I just like that this bag chose to just leave that off and allows you to just have a big open space where you can pack however you feel comfortable. If you want to separate your shoes or your dirty clothes from the rest of your stuff, you can, you know, get a shoe bag or get some sort of laundry bag. They sell a lot of those for cheap on Amazon. So I really like the flexibility that this bag offers with the packing. As I mentioned, the compression straps are really nice. The only thing that I kind of didn't like about the straps is that the clip on the inside, so this side is really long, it makes it really easy to pull, and then as you're filling the bag up, there's no issues. But if you fill the bag up and you're not careful with the clip, it can be really difficult to find it. You know, once you fill everything up and it's really deep, you have to kind of dig in and then make sure to hold that up so that you can clip in. So I just wish that they had given a little bit more slack here, or made this part a little bit longer on the strap. But that's a minor complaint, and you know, if you're aware of that, you can kind of make sure that you leave it out and make it easy to snap in after you're done packing. But okay, back to the stuff that I had packed. So just to summarize, I had my 5 t-shirts, I had a pair of shorts. I actually managed to fit 3 jeans in here, which is probably more than I would need for a week, but I was really just trying to fill it out with as much stuff as possible. Then I have a few more socks and a few more underwear here. And then on the very bottom, I also have my DOP kit. So this is the Air DOP kit, and I've done a full review for this in the past. It's really, really cool. So I'll link that in the description below if you want to check that out. And then that's it for as far as my travel, my clothing essentials, and my toiletry essentials. As you can see, here's the bag, just empty, standing straight up. Here you can see both sides of the compression straps. And really simple, but I love how spacious this is. And one thing that I also really like is just how light the bag feels when it's empty. You know, some of the other travel packs that I've reviewed, I guess in an effort to make sure that the bag is really durable, they kind of use materials that are very heavy. And, you know, I'm not trying to, I think this material feels very durable and it looks like it's very long lasting, but somehow they've made the bag feel very light. So even when it's empty, it just feels like you're not really wearing anything, which is really nice, you know, when it's something you'll likely have to carry around with you all day. So besides allowing you to pack all your clothing and providing a few organizational options on the front, one thing I really love about this bag is that it's also kind of meant for business travelers, in the sense that it offers a really, really cool laptop compartment. So it opens from the back and it has a full zipper around the laptop compartment that allows it to lay flat for TSA compliance, which means that you can just unzip it, lay it down flat, and just go right on through security. In addition to that, it has the laptop pocket is really cool. I haven't seen this on a lot of bags before. It's adjustable. So if you have a wider laptop or you have a taller laptop, it looks like this could easily hold a 17-inch laptop. And you can adjust the straps here based on the width and height of your laptop. So I have in here a MacBook Air 13-inch. As you can see, there's a little bit of a leftover strap here. So that's one thing that I didn't really know. I suppose you could make the straps a little bit wider here and then pull this down here if you really care about keeping the strap secure. I haven't seen any issues with just leaving a little bit of slack here, but as I said, it's really cool that you can just lay it down flat. I also really like that this serves as a pull tab, so if you have a smaller laptop and it sinks to the bottom, you can just pull this up and then your laptop will come out and you're good to go. So really convenient for getting through airport security. I love this. For any bag that I'm gonna take my laptop on, this is kind of a very, very key feature, because it's really annoying to have to pull your laptop out of your bag, put it in a bin. You know, you're taking your shoes off, you're taking your jewelry off, you're taking your toiletries and bottles off, and then you get to the other side and you have to put everything in. The last thing you want to worry about is whether you're going to forget your laptop or somebody's going to take it. So this is a key feature. And then on the other side of the bag, when you unzip it, they offer a few more organizational options for, you know, they have a clear zipper mesh pocket here where you can put your charger. So, you know, I would put my MacBook charger in there, maybe some of my phone charger, an external battery. They have pockets here for pens and pencils, or for a stylus. Over here, there's just kind of an all-purpose pocket, and it sinks pretty deep, so you could easily put an external battery there, or you know, some more cables. So just kind of a random accessory pocket that serves a lot of different purposes. And then in this pocket over here, I believe this is meant to serve kind of as a tablet pocket if you want to take your tablet with you. It's really big. You can almost fit a whole other laptop in here. I've put in my Bluetooth keyboard just to kind of show, give an idea of how deep into the space that's available there. But that's a really good multi-purpose pocket. You can put documents there as well. And it has a Velcro closing to just kind of keep things organized and secure. And so this offers a ton of options for when you're traveling. I really, really like this. I could definitely see myself for, you know, a short business trip, just packing in the essentials, throwing my laptop and charger in there, and just being ready to go. So I definitely recommend this if you're worried about tech organization. The other cool thing that it has here is kind of a secret pocket for, you know, more valuable items such as your wallet or your passport, or your boarding passes. If you're just walking around the airport and you want to take the bag off and just grab something quickly, you can put it in there, in this pocket up here. This is on the side with the strap, so it's facing your back, which means it would be really hard to get to. It's also kind of well hidden here too. Like, unless you look very closely, you probably wouldn't even be able to see that there's a pocket there if you're just, if somebody's walking by you or something like that. And so as far as kind of like carrying options, the bag has a really nice sturdy handle here. It's really comfortable to hold and would probably make it easy to help pick up and put into an overhead compartment. The back here is nice and padded. It's really comfortable to wear. As you can see in the shot here, I have it on with all the stuff that I had taken out earlier. And as you can see, the bag, you know, it opens up quite a bit. It's a pretty bulky bag once you fill it up completely, but that's because it can hold a lot. But it's still comfortable to wear. It's not too heavy. This little padding right here feels comfortable on your back. The straps themselves are really comfortable as well. You know, they're a little thin, but from what I've seen so far, they hold up well during the day. You know, I haven't felt any fatigue or anything from holding them from the bag straps specifically. The main problem that I've realized with this bag is actually that it's missing a sternum strap and a waist strap. So, you know, for normal bags, that wouldn't really be that big of an issue to me. But for a bag like this, which is meant to hold a ton of stuff and which is meant to be kind of for travel and maybe even to wear around the city during a long day, I really think that it's strange that was omitted, because it would really help with managing the weight on the back and kind of distributing everything well and helping to reduce tiredness from wearing it all day. So that's a little bit strange. I don't know why those weren't included. I don't know if there's any that they sell separately that you might be able to attach. But that's really the main complaint I have on the bag, which in retrospect is not that big of a deal, because all the other features of the bag are great. I love the look. I love the materials. I really love how much stuff you can actually fit in here. And it doesn't even look that big considering how much stuff I've put in. So that kind of surprised me in a good way. And as I mentioned, I really loved kind of all the organization options that it also has for your technology. So all in all, I definitely recommend checking this bag out. I was also really surprised by the price. I paid about $100 for it on Amazon. And for bags of this size and quality that I've seen from competing companies, you know, it's usually closer to the $200 range. So this is really a great deal. And if you're looking for a bag that you can use for weekend getaways or just for quick business trips that has that can hold a ton of stuff and looks pretty nice, I definitely recommend giving this bag a shot. So I hope that was able to provide some helpful insights into the Arcedo Faro. If you guys like this review, please go ahead and give us a like below, and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming reviews. Thank you so much.